These are the questions that you have had the opportunity to log on to CBN.com with and ask Pat. So we're going to start with James, who begins by saying, Pat, I've heard that diet sodas can actually cause you to gain weight. It may even be dangerous. Is this true?
James, I can't say enough bad things about some of the diet products that are out there. Mm-hmm. The truth is, if you take diet products, they will make you gain weight. There's no question. It'll also set up a craving in your body. You want more because it doesn't satisfy what you need. The big problem is a substance called NutraSweet. NutraSweet. And you find that in your label. It'll say sweetened with NutraSweet. Mm-hmm. Now, when they do a chemical analysis of NutraSweet, they find that they can isolate formaldehyde. Mm. And when they isolate formaldehyde, that's what you use to, you know,
preserve dead people.
That's what it is. And this stuff has been linked to cancer. Mm. It has been linked in some studies to Alzheimer's. It does terrible things to people. It gives people, feelings of despair, emotional trauma. You just go through the list of bad stuff it does. It's also been linked to blindness. It takes away your visual acuity, and it certainly takes away your memory. I mean, that's just a few of the stuff.
Now, in the diet soda.
You're going to drink a soda that'll give you all those things? I mean, that's crazy.
Water.
Yeah.
Water.
Now, you can drink fruit juices, and you can, because they're fattening too, but you can drink water. And there are substances that don't have that junk in them. But mm-hmm. NutraSweet is bad news, and it will hurt you badly. I couldn't say it any more positively. Mm-hmm. Don't do it.
How do you really feel, Pat? I really didn't understand how you really felt about diet soda.
Well, we've been chasing that baby for the last 15 or 20 years, and it's just, it's horrible what it does to people.
And just on a side note, too, the normal soda isn't good for you either because it has, like, high fructose corn syrup in it, which is an addictive agent, and it just makes you yucky. Okay.
But it's better if you're going to drink a regular Coke than to drink those diet things.
That's true.
All right.
Or water. Hillary.
Or water, especially water.
Hillary writes in and says, when I lose weight, my family's jealousy was unbearable. If I didn't eat the junk food they liked, they treated it as a personal affront. So I gained back a lot of weight. What can I do to protect myself from my family's negative influence?
Get away from them.
Now, Pat.
You can't
just mess your family up.
If the family's going to lead you into stuff that will destroy your life, why should you allow them to destroy you? You just say, I'm not going to do it. And then they'll mark it down. Well, old, what's your name?
Hillary.
Well, old Hillary is a little bit weird, but that's the way it is. I mean, just get used to the fact that they're going to mark you down as a weirdo. All right, be a weirdo, but be a healthy weirdo. And, I mean, that's just the way it is. And if people want to kill themselves with their mouth, we'll let them do it, but you don't have to go along with them.
Can I say something, Pat? Okay.
Child, you can always say something. What do you want to say?
All right, Hillary, here's the deal. If your family starts tripping because you lose weight, your significance is not in any other person's opinion but the Lord's, period. Rock your stuff. Be healthy, because the only person that is really significant to you is you.
That's so utterly spiritual. Thank you. All right, what's next?
I'm trying to be spiritual today.
All right, you guys.
All right. Betty writes in and says, every night when I get home from work, I start eating, and I continue eating until I go to bed. No matter how hard I try, I haven't been able to stop this cycle. What do you suggest I do to overcome this problem?
Betty, when you get home, put on a pair of walking or jogging shoes and go out for a couple of mile walk. First thing. Take a little water, as Christy's been saying. Get out of the house. When you sit down, you sit in front of television, whatever habit pattern you're into, break it. Mm-hmm. And the other thing is, if you want to munch on something, get something like roasted soybeans or celery or carrot strips or things like that, and munch on them. They'll fill you up, and you won't have this other. You know, every time you start, you know, when you eat fattening things, you eat sweets, that sets up a craving that you want more. It's like alcohol. The more you drink, the more you want. So the more that stuff you eat, the more you will want. But if you eat, you just take protein. If nothing else, have some strips of beef jerky or something. Anything besides what you're eating, mm-hmm. but that'll satisfy those cravings. But more than anything, get out of the house with your walking shoes on and go for a very long brisk walk.
You know when that happens to me, Pat, is when I'm not eating enough during the day.
Yeah.
Because it's like I get so busy, I'm doing this and I'm doing that, and by the time I get home and I settle, I'm like, whew, give me a burger. So yeah. if you eat more during the day,
well,
you won't be starving at night.
Actually, if you don't eat a good breakfast, you set up a craving all day long. You're not having enough nutrients, so you need to have a nutritious breakfast.
That's true. What'd you eat today for breakfast?
Oatmeal and some multi-grain toast.
That sounds yummy.
Oh, is this so yummy it hurt? All right.
Okay, Robert writes in and says, I recently started taking salmon oil, or salmon, people say it differently, as a dietary supplement, but heard that it could have harmful levels of polychlorinated, what's that word, Pat? Biphenols?
Biphenols.
Something
PCBs.
Like that. Yeah, PCBs. The label says the oil is molecularly distilled. Does that process take out the PCBs?
Yes, it does. Oh, molecularly distilled takes out all the man-made impurities. And if you can get it, it'll have a higher content of omega-3s. So that's kind of good. But you've got to make sure you read the label, because if it doesn't have it, a lot of fish just has mercury. It has other things in it because they, up the food chain, they're eating these little fish that have mercury. And where does they get the mercury? They get it from us. We mm-hmm. dump it into our oceans and streams and so forth. So, but the molecular processing takes out those impurities.
Hey, speaking of which, we have time for one more question.
All right.
And you're talking about fish, so the next question is going to be about fish. Pat.
Yes.
We always hear about how great fish, fresh. I thought it said fish. Sorry. Fresh fruits are for us, but they have a lot of sugar in them, right? Are we supposed to avoid this type of high sugar food?
I tell you what, empty calories are your problem. Orange juice, any kind of fruit juice that doesn't have the fiber with it, empty calories. And if you eat, half a gallon of orange juice, it won't help. It won't help you. It'll hurt you. So the big thing is eat fruits in moderation. Everything, if you do it in excess, will cause problems. And too much fruit can deteriorate your bone structure, mm-hmm. Lead to cavities in your teeth, and it can do other bad things to you. So fruit is wonderful, but like an apple. Eat an apple.
Mm-hmm.
Don't eat a bushel basket of apples.
Exactly.
All right.
Or an apple pie. Apple pie is not bad for you, though.
If you're trying to lose weight, it's not good for you, but if you just like apple pie, they're delicious. But anyhow,
I know.
One apple is good for you. One plum is good for you. A serving of cherries is good for you. A serving of blueberries is mm-hmm. wonderful for you, but you don't just pig out on them, that's all.